Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, in the last lecture we have did a numerical based on Nernst equation. So let us do that kind of numerical but with different data. So above question has a numerical which is based on Nernst equation. It has that we have to calculate the cell potential of the cell in which Zn is been converted into Zn2 plus and the concentration of Zn2 plus is 0.6 molar, and in this case the hydrogen electrode is been also used, so the concentration of hydrogen in this case is 1.2 molar, and platinum is used as an inert electrode, and the concentration of or the I could say the cell potential, standard cell potential of E0 of Zn is given as minus 0.763 volt, while that of, since we know that the concentration or since we know the cell potential or standard cell potential of hydrogen is always 0 volt, so therefore the hydrogen has a cell potential of 0 volt. So because of all this thing we have to calculate what would be the cell potential, that is E cell. So in this case we have to calculate what would be the E cell of the this galvanic cell. So now let us first of all calculate, or let us first of all do the cell reaction, and then let us see that what would be the product and what would be the reactant and how many number of moles of electrons are being involved in the half cell reaction. So let us do it. So first of all the cell reaction can be written as you know at anode oxidation always occurs, while at cathode reduction occurs. So in this case zinc has been acted like an anode, so therefore zinc has been converted, the solid zinc has been converted into Zn2 plus. By eliminating two electron, while that of the hydrogen, in this case hydrogen is undergoing reduction by accepting electrons to form H2. So let us see how can we write it. If H plus will accept one electron, it will form H atom, but hydrogen exists in a gaseous form, so therefore to make it in a gaseous form we are balancing it, and yes, now hence we could get what would be the overall reduction at cathode. So the net cell reaction will be this two electron, this two electron will cancel out each other, and the thing that we could get is solid zinc plus two times of H plus, that is giving us Zn2 plus plus molecular form of hydrogen. So these are the product and this is the reactant that we have got by getting what would be the cell reaction of this experiment. So because of this, now it would be very much easy to calculate what would be the cell potential, but before that we have to calculate what would be the standard cell potential of the whole experiment or of the whole cell. So we have the formula that E naught cell is equals to E naught of cathode minus E dot of anode. In this case the cathode was being behaved by H2, so therefore E dot of H2 which is 0.0 volt, and for anode it was found to be zinc, so therefore E dot of H2 minus E dot of zinc. The value of H2, E dot of H2, that is the standard potential of H2, was or is 0 minus of the, for zinc it was calculated as 0.763. so if I add this thing I could get 0.763 volt as the E naught cell. So let us calculate what would be the number of moles of electrons that are involved in half of the cell reaction. So the number of electrons that have been involved in the half cell reaction are 2. So therefore, in this case, the N has a value of 2. So now it would be very much easy to calculate that what would be the product and what would be the reactant. Therefore, E cell is equals to E naught cell minus 0.0592 divided by N log of product divided by reactant. So in this case, the E naught cell that we have calculated was 0.763 minus 0.0592 divided by 2 into log of the product. In this case, the product were Zn2 plus and H2, while the reactant were Zn that was present in solid form plus 2H plus. So let us write it by observing this thing. So Zn2 plus is giving us a concentration that has been mentioned in the cell formula, and the concentration of H plus is also being provided to us. So this two, when are present in elemental form or in molecular form, will have an concentration as 1 itself. So I would substitute the values here. So the thing that I could get is 0.763 minus 0.0592 divided by 2 log of the concentration of Zn2 plus was found to be 0.6 molar, while that of the concentration of H plus was found to be 1.2 molar. So let us calculate this thing and estimate what would be the answer. So the answer is 0.763 into 0.0592 into 2 divided by 2 into minus 0.3010. This will lead to the answer E cell, which is 0.763 plus 0.0592 divided by 2 into 0.3010. So the answer will be 0.771 volt. So this is how we have calculated the cell potential. It was so much easy. So thank you friends for watching this video, and please share this video with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe to Ikeda channel. Thank you so much.